In his past life, Nakkin was a simple man that loved playing his violin. But the village did not appreciate his talent. People would frequently bully him. And the only soul that did not was a girl that Nakkin fell in love with. One day, the bullying and beatings became so severe that Nakkin's anger finally overtook him. He marched into the village, playing forbidden melodies that made everyone dance until their flesh and bone got worn down. They eventually died, leaving behind shuffling corpses, still trying to dance to Nakkin's melodies. His love was not spared death either. Devastated, Nakkin left the town and lived by the lake, drowning in his sorrow, where he still lures people with his deadly music. closer and closer. He felt as if a darkness took hold of his heart and filled it with fear. Then there was a light. Tuva was a light in the darkness. She had filled his heart with courage, and the stone with her radiance. The bramble covers all where darkness has taken hold, Tuva said. Follow the light. You will find what you are searching for within the mountain.
Thank you.
land was once a peaceful kingdom with a great king. Now, his image embodied the darkness that had drowned the world in Bramble. Laemus would always look after his only friend. Olle felt a chill as he saw the warnings for desperate mothers carrying their infants. They pleaded with them not to carry out the unspeakable acts they had set their minds to.
in the transcendent and surrender, to be received into the arms of splendor. Behold the transmutation into gold. Soon a god emerges from the mold. No longer human, brittle and alone, a god is reborn, seated on a throne.
The witch was ahead of him. Olle knew he had to hurry before she could complete the ritual. If he did not catch up with the woman, the swamp would swallow another child. But he did not know that someone else wanted to hold him back. A midwife who wanted more dark souls to take care of. Ola had been too late. At least he could give the child a proper burial, so that it would not become another dark soul. There was a light in the darkness. Guilt and sorrow weighed him down, but the warm glow felt comforting. Follow the light, Tuva had said, and he trusted her. Lichtgruber was older than the mountain, almost as old as the world itself. He was the keeper of secrets, the gatherer of stories. Long ago, there was a peaceful kingdom that lacked an heir to the throne. King Nils and his queen Magdalena had waited for a long time, and at last she was expecting a child. She gave birth to the longed-for son, and they named him Ulrik. But suddenly, doctors crowded around the queen's bed. Magdalena succumbed to the labors of childbirth. The love of his life was gone. Weighed down by sorrow, King Nils approached his autumn. Meanwhile, Ulrik grew into a young boy full of life. The prince was the only thing that kept the darkness at bay in his heart. One day, Prince Ulrik fell ill. The doctors tried everything, but he grew weaker and weaker. They told King Nils about a mythical flower that witches were rumored to use to heal any illness. King Nils searched the whole kingdom for the flower to no avail, and his campaign soon became a gruesome witch hunt. His path was lined with the witches he had slain, but the flower was nowhere to be found. Ulle wished he could stay in the warm light of the library. But he knew that he needed to reach the mountain and find Lillemor. Suddenly, he heard a familiar voice. "Follow me, little brother. I will protect you." Ulla, what have you done? Tuva's voice called out to him.